On the Medical Watch tonight, the University of Chicago Medicine performed a record number of heart transplants this year.
That medical team there did 66 heart transplants. That broke last year's Illinois record of 61, which University of Chicago also set. The medical center also set a hospital record for the most multi-organ transplants with 37. Dr. Christopher Salerno is a cardiac surgeon and surgical director of the Heart Transplant and Mechanical Assist Device Program at the University of Chicago Medical Center. And there you see him. He's joining us now live to talk a little bit more about their very busy year. First of all, hello to you.
Hi, how are you guys?
All right, let's begin with these numbers because they are very impressive as we read through some of the information and some of the data. How do you think your team was able to do that?
You know, I think we kind of have a few foundations. You know, we're lucky enough to have a very experienced team, three really experienced surgeons, fantastic cardiologists, and a great anesthesia team, which helps us both in the operating room and in the ICU. A lot of this really is up to the generosity of families who are willing to donate organs. We sort of focus on some very high-risk patients, and we get patients not just from the Chicagoland area, but from across the country. So it's a commitment to excellence and a great team.
So I know the experience and the expertise, I mean, that goes a long way, but it's also not possible without, as you said, donors whose families are willing to share the gift of life. Where are donor rates right now? I'm sure they could be better, but is that been a better picture?
It has, actually. You know, over the last few years, the number of donors and organ utilization, specifically for heart transplants, has gone up. One of the new sources is something called DCD donors, or these are donors who the hearts actually stopped beating prior to transplant. So thankfully, there is an increased awareness of organ donation and an increased number of donors.
Okay, I'm sure you track some of the other hospitals and kind of how they're doing. I know that you guys are doing very well with these impressive numbers of 66, but do you have any ideas to how other local hospitals or even nationwide, how hospitals are faring when it comes to organ donation and these transplants?
So this will likely be a record year nationally for heart transplant, probably a little over 4,000.
Wow.
I think the local hospitals, the ones I'm most familiar with, being Advocate Northwestern, are seeing a slight uptick, not to the extent that we are. I think what makes us unique is the ability to take on some very high-risk transplants that have been turned down from other facilities.
I didn't hear you get into this here, but it's also kind of noteworthy that the University of Chicago had the highest one-year survival rate and the lowest wait time to get in to do the transplant. And that's a separate issue altogether. How were we able to achieve that as well?
Yeah, that is really an amazing thing, the survival. So I think, again, it starts with expertise and commitment to excellence. In terms of outcomes. And, you know, as a surgeon, I do probably the easiest part of these procedures sometimes, and that's just implanting the heart. But it's really the selection and the care afterwards, which are unbelievably important to the long-term success. The wait times are really a program commitment to being willing to travel and take some donors that may be extended distances or other centers have turned down. Hmm. Our experience allows us to take an extended pool of donors from greater distances and therefore increase our transplant numbers.
All right, Dr. Christopher Salerno, we appreciate your time and we wish you a very happy new year.
Happy new year, thank you for the opportunity.
And keep up the good work, for sure.